This is a did you know about dogs and cats that the others didn't tell you about. For the first time, prepare to really know. Welcome, pet lovers, pet parents, and pet enthusiasts to our channel, GNA Pet Solutions. In this special video documentary, we will delve into the fascinating world of our beloved canine friends. From the unique communication styles to the wonders of their physiology and genetics, we've got it all covered. So let's dive in. Our video today begins with our best friend, dogs. We will start the exploration of the intricate world of canine communication as we delve into the subtle art of expressions that make our furry friends such enchanting companions. Dogs, with their wagging tails and soulful eyes, possess a remarkable ability to convey a myriad of emotions, often leaving us captivated by the depths of their feelings. One of the most intriguing aspects of canine expression is the infamous submissive grin. This subtle yet enduring gesture is a testament to the emotional intelligence of dogs. When a dog offers a submissive grin, it is as if they are sharing a secret language with us, a language that transcends words and is deeply rooted in the bonds of trust and affection. The submissive grin is characterized by a relaxed mouth, often pulled back at the corners, and exposed front teeth. You've seen it. Accompanied by a wagging tail and perhaps a gentle gaze, this expression signifies not only happiness, but also a sense of submission and deference. It is a dog's way of saying, I trust you, and I acknowledge your leadership. But the art of expression in dogs goes beyond the submissive grin. Dogs communicate with their entire bodies using a rich tapestry of movements and postures to convey their feelings. The tilt of the head, for example, can signify curiosity or attentiveness. When a dog cocks its head to the side, it's as if they are trying to understand us better, capturing our attention with their enduring curiosity. Eyes, often referred to as the windows to the soul, play a crucial role in the canine expression. A soft, soulful gaze can melt the hearts of even the toughest individuals. Conversely, a direct, unwavering stare might be a sign of alertness or assertiveness. Dogs can communicate a range of emotions through their eyes, creating a deep and intimate connection between them and their human companions. The language of canine expression extends to their ears too. Ears held high might indicate excitement or curiosity, while flattened ears can signify fear or submission. Each subtle movement and nuance of a dog's body language contributes to the rich tapestry of their emotional communication. As we unravel the language of our four-legged friends, it becomes clear that their expressions are not arbitrary. They are finely tuned signals crafted by emotions, by evolution, and refined through centuries of companionship with humans. Dogs have adapted to read and respond to human emotions, and in turn, they use their own expressions to convey their needs, desires, and the depths of their emotional states. In the subtle art of expression, dogs teach us the beauty, I should say, of non-verbal communication. They remind us that a glance, a wag tail, or a well-timed head tilt can speak volumes. This silent language creates a profound connection, allowing us to understand and respond to our canine companions on a level that transcends words. So pause this video, gather your family members, get your popcorn, your sodas, and even your notebooks, and join us at the GNA Pet Solutions channel as we begin this journey into a world of not just canine expression, but their biology, anatomy, physiology, and genetics, where every wag of the tail, every tilt of the head tells a story of loyalty, love, and the timeless bond between humans and their beloved dogs. Together, let's celebrate the subtle tapestry that makes our furry friends not just pets, but cherished members of our family. I think it would be unfair, though, not to talk about this title, man's best friend. It deserves a few minutes of mention, if you would ask me. So pay attention. The history of why dogs are often referred to as man's best friend is a fascinating one that spans centuries of human-dog companionship. This enduring phrase encapsulates the deep and special bond that has developed between humans and dogs over time. Number one, ancient origins. The relationship between humans and dogs can be traced back thousands of years. Dogs were among the first animals to be domesticated by humans, primarily for their ability as hunting and guarding partners. Their early partnership laid the foundation for a strong emotional connection. Number two, their loyalty and companionship. Dogs have consistently exhibited qualities that endure them to humans, such as loyalty, affection, and a strong desire to be near their human companions. These traits have made dogs cherished companions throughout history. Number three, cultural and literacy influence. The idea of dogs as loyal friends has been prevalent in various cultures and literary works. For example, in Greek mythology, the famous hound Argos waited patiently for his master Odysseus to return. Shakespeare also recognized the special bond in his play Timon of Athens, where he wrote, "The more I see of man, the more I like dogs." Number four, contributions to human life. Over time, dogs have contributed significantly to human life. They have aided in hunting, herding of livestock, and serving as working dogs in various roles, such as search and rescue, police work, and as service animals for people with disabilities, and even some aspects of mental illness. Number five, emotional support. Dogs have been known to provide emotional support and companionship to their owners. They can often comfort them during difficult times and are often attuned to their human emotional state, making them excellent therapy animals. Number six, contemporary symbolism. In more recent history, the term man's best friend has become a symbol of the special connection between humans and dogs. It is commonly used to highlight the trust, loyalty, and unwavering friendship that dogs provide to their human companions. The phrase, man's best friend, perfectly encapsulates the enduring partnership and deep emotional connection that humans and dogs share. Dogs, more than any other living creature, possess the sum of qualities that allow them to bond so closely with human beings that they are called, as we have mentioned, man's best friend. Somewhat questionable title. Sometimes they rival and surpass the friendship of even other human beings. Dogs have earned this title through their unwavering loyalty, companionship, and the countless ways in which they enrich our lives. Let us jump into this dog thing. Hi, just a reminder that you're viewing the GNA Pet Solutions channel on the YouTube. Today we will continue by jumping into some of the more fascinating characteristics of man's best friend, as we know, the dog. The first one that we identify is the exceptional sense of smell. Did you know that a dog's sense of smell is not only powerful, but mind-blowingly intricate? They have up to 3 million smell receptors in their noses, compared to about 5 million in humans. The part of the brain dedicated to analyzing smell, just analyze smell, is about 40 times larger than ours. This makes dogs' noses not only adorable, but also incredibly efficient at detecting scents, which explains their talent in tracking and the search and rescue operations. Let's dive a little deeper into the fascinating world of dogs' sense of smell. So the olfactory receptors, as mentioned, dogs have around 3 million such receptors in their noses. And these receptors are specialized cells that detect and process odors, odor molecules. In comparison, as we've said, human beings have about 5 million of such receptors. Number two, there's what we call the Jacobson organ, also known as the vosomonasal organ. Jacobson organ is an additional scent detecting structure found in many animals, including dogs. It enhances their ability to detect pheromones, chemical signals that convey information between individuals of the same species. Number three, scent discrimination. Dogs have an incredible ability to discriminate between different scents. They can detect and identify a myriad of odors, making them invaluable in tasks such as search and rescue, detection of illegal substances, and even medical conditions like certain types of cancers. Number four, you have a secondary olfactory system. Dogs not only have a highly developed main olfactory system, but also a secondary one called the accessory olfactory system. This system is responsible for processing pheromones and play a role in social and reproductive behaviors. Number five, scent memory. A dog's brain is equipped with a well-developed olfactory memory. This means they can remember and recall specific scents over a long period, which contributes to their ability to track scents over varied terrains. Number six, breathing technique. Dogs have a unique breathing technique that helps them sample scents more efficiently. They exhale through slits at the sides of their noses, creating a constant circulation of air that allows them to continuously sample sense. Isn't that amazing? Number 7, individual nose prints. Similar to human fingerprints, each dog's nose has a unique pattern of ridges and creases. Nose prints can be used for identification purposes, and no two dogs have the same nose prints. Understanding the intricacies of a dog's sense of smell not only highlights their biological marvel, but also emphasizes the important roles they play in various human activities and relationships. The second one, exceptional hearing. Dogs boast an extraordinary sense of hearing that surpasses human capabilities. And here are some of the fascinating details. Number 1, their frequency range. Dogs can hear a broader range of frequencies than humans. While humans typically hear around between 20 kilohertz, 20 to 20,000 kilohertz, dogs can detect frequencies as low as 40 hertz and as high as 65,000 hertz. This expanded range allows them to pick up high-pitched sounds such as a dog whistle that are inaudible to us. Secondly, sound localization. Dogs excel in locating the source of a sound. Their ears are designed for effective sound localization with the ability to move independently. This feature helps them determine the direction and distance of a sound, contributing to their keen awareness of their surroundings. Thirdly, selective hearing. Dogs are not just great at hearing, they also exhibit a selective ability. They can focus on specific sounds while filtering out others. This skill is particularly useful for working dogs, such as those trained for search and rescue missions or police work. The ear anatomy. The anatomy of a dog's ear plays a crucial role in its exceptional hearing. Their ears are designed with a more significant number of muscles, allowing for better control and movement. You've seen dogs do that. Additionally, the shape of their ears, whether erect or floppy, can influence the way they capture and process sound. Communication through sounds. Dogs use a variety of vocalizations to communicate, and their acute hearing contributes to this form of expression. From barks and whines and to howls, each sound serves a specific purpose, whether it's alerting the human to a potential threat or signaling playfulness with other dogs. The third sense, their remarkable vision. Dogs' eyesight is another remarkable aspect of their biology. Let's explore some intriguing facts. Their color perception. Contrary to the belief that dogs see the world in black and white, they do have some color vision. While not as vibrant as humans, their eyes contain two types of color receptors, cones, that allow them to perceive shades of blue and yellow. Night vision. Dogs are crepuscular animals, meaning they are most active during dusk and dawn. To accommodate this lifestyle, their eyes are equipped with a higher number of rod cells, which are sensitive to low light. This adaptation gives them superior night vision compared to humans. Their peripheral vision. The placement of a dog's eyes on the sides of the head grant them a wide field of view, enhancing their peripheral vision. This trait is a result of their evolutionary history as predators, allowing them to detect movement from various angles, a valuable skill in the wild. Flicker fusion frequency. Dogs have a higher flicker fusion frequency than humans, meaning they can detect fast movements more efficiently. This ability is particularly advantageous in activities such as tracking fast-moving objects or prey. Tear satin lines. Some dog breeds have a tear stain line on their faces. These stains are a result of tear production to keep their eyes moist. Interestingly, the color of these stains can vary on factors such as diet and genetics. We will now look at their complex brain structure. A dog's brain is a marvel of biological engineering, showcasing remarkably complex structures. Here are some intriguing aspects of their cognitive anatomy. The brain size. While dogs' brains are not as large as those of some other mammals, they exhibit a remarkable degree of folding, known as gyrification. These folding increases the surface area of the brain, allowing for more neurons and consequently greater cognitive abilities. Scent and memory integration. The olfactory bulb responsible for processing smell is proportionally larger in dogs compared to humans. What makes this even more fascinating is the close connection between the olfactory bulb and the area of the brain associated with memory and emotions. This integration explains why smells are closely tied to a dog's memory and emotional experience. Problem-solving skills. Dogs exhibit problem-solving skills, and their brains have areas dedicated to spatial understanding and manipulation. This is evident in tasks such as navigating through complex environments or figuring out how to access a hidden treat. Emotional center. Dogs have a well-developed limbic system, often referred to as the emotional center of the brain. This contributes to their ability to experience a range of emotions, including joy, fear, and attachment. It also plays a role in their social behaviors and interactions. Mirror neurons. Dogs possess mirror neurons, a type of brain cell that responds equally when they perform an action and when they observe that same action in others. This neural mechanism contributes to their capacity for social learning and imitation. Unique vocalization abilities. Dogs are known for their diverse vocalization, and their vocal anatomy plays a crucial role in this aspect. Let's explore some of the intriguing facts about their ability to communicate through sounds. A variety of barks. Dogs use different types of barks to convey various messages. A high-pitched bark may indicate excitement or playfulness, while a low, sustained bark can signal a potential threat. Their ability to modulate the pitch and intensity of their barks allow for a rich and nuanced form of communication. Howling harmonics. Howling is not just a haunting, beautiful sound. It serves practical purposes for dogs. Howls can carry over long distances, facilitating communication between individuals. Additionally, the harmonics in a howl can convey information about the howler's size, age, and even emotional state. Whining and whimpering. Dogs use whining and whimpering sounds to express a range of emotions, from anxiety and discomfort to seeking attention or expressing submission. The pitch and duration of these sounds can vary based on the context and the individual dog's personality. Growling as communication. Growling is a versatile form of communication for dogs. While it can signal aggression, it can also serve as a warning or a way for dogs to express discomfort. The rhythmic and low frequency nature of growls make them distinctive and easily recognizable. Yipping and playfulness. Some dogs exhibit yipping or playful vocalization during moments of excitement or play. These high-pitched, quick sounds are often associated with positive emotions and can serve as a way for dogs to engage with each other or express their enthusiasm. Now, the adaptable digestive system of dogs. Dogs have a digestive system uniquely suited to their dietary needs and evolutionary history. Here are more intriguing facts about them and their digestive biology. Carnivorous ancestry. While domestic dogs have adapted to a more omnivorous diet due to their association with humans, their digestive systems still reflects their carnivorous ancestry. Their teeth are designed for tearing and crushing, and their short digestive tract is optimized for processing animal proteins efficiently. Stomach acidity. Dogs have highly acidic stomachs with a pH level much lower than that of humans. This acidity serves multiple purposes, including breaking down proteins and killing potentially harmful bacteria present in raw meat. It's a crucial adaptation for their historic role as scavengers and hunters. Rapid digestion. The canine digestive system is relatively short compared to other animals. This rapid digestion is an adaptation to the quick consumption of meals in the wild, where competition for food could be fierce. It also explains why dogs may have more frequent but smaller bowel movements. Dietary adaptability. Dogs exhibit a remarkable ability to adapt to different diets. While their ancestors primarily consumed raw meat, domestic dogs can thrive on a variety of diets, including commercial dog food and even vegetarian or vegan diets with proper nutritional supplementation. Coprophagia. Though not universal, some dogs engage in this coprophagia, which is the consumption of feces. While this behavior may seem unappealing to humans, it has evolutionary roots. In the wild, it could be a survival strategy to extract additional nutrients from the remains of prey or to keep the den clean to avoid detection by predators. paws, as in P-A-W-S, and paw pads, as in P-A-W-P-A-D-S. A dog's paws are a fascinating aspect of their anatomy, contributing to various aspects of their daily lives. Here are some intriguing facts. 1. Paw pads and traction. The texture and structure of a dog's paw pads are designed for optimal traction. These pads provide a non-slip surface, allowing dogs to navigate various terrains with ease. The paw pads also contain sweat glands, which assists in temperature regulation, especially in hot weather. Digital pads and balance. Dogs have digital pads, often referred to as toe beans, beneath each toe on their paws. These pads contribute to their balance and stability, particularly during activities that require precision, such as climbing or navigating uneven surfaces. The softness and flexibility of these pads absorb shock and provide a cushioning landing. Scent glands. Paw pads contain scent glands that release pheromones unique to each dog's. When a dog scrapes or makes a surface with its paw, they are leaving scent markers behind. This behavior is a form of communication, allowing them to establish territory or convey information to other dogs. Webbed paws. Some dog breeds have webbed paws, a trait that enhances their swimming abilities. The webbing increases surface area, enabling more efficient propulsion in water. Breeds like the Labrador Retriever and Newfoundlands, known for their love of water, often exhibit this adaptation. Digging instinct. Dogs' strong instinct to dig is closely tied to their paw anatomy, as in P-A-W, not P-O-O-R. The curved shape of their claws and the strength of their leg muscles makes digging a natural behavior. In the wild, digging serves various purposes, from creating a comfortable den to burying food for later consumption. Efficient thermal regulation. Dogs have evolved with a set of mechanisms for regulating their body's temperature effectively. Here are some remarkable facts about their thermal biology. Panting as cooling. Unlike humans, dogs don't sweat as their primary means of cooling. Instead, they rely on panting, the rapid inhalation and exhalation of air through the mouth helps to dissipate heat, and the moisture of their tongue and respiratory surfaces contributes to the cooling effect. Insulating fur. A dog's coat acts as both insulation and protection. In cold weather, their fur traps air close to the body, creating a layer of insulation. In hot weather, the same fur also provides shade and reflects sunlight, preventing excessive heat absorption. Thermoregulation through paw pads. In addition to sweating through their paw pads, dogs can also release heat through their sweat glands on their noses. These less hairy and more exposed areas allow for efficient heat dissipation, especially during physical activities. Vasodilation and cooling. Dogs have a unique ability to regulate blood flow to specific areas of their bodies. During hot weather, vasodilation occurs where blood vessels near the surface of the skin expand, allowing heat to dissipate. This is why a dog's ear, which has many blood vessels, may feel warm to the touch. Adaptation to cold. Breeds that originated in colder climates have adaptations for cold weather. These can include a thicker undercoat, smaller ears, and fur-covered paw pads. These features help them conserve body heat in chilly conditions. Whiskers and sensory information. A dog's whiskers, also known as vibrissae, plays a crucial role in providing sensory information. Here are some fascinating facts about these specialized hairs. Tactile sensitivity. Whiskers are deeply embedded in a dog's body, connected to the nervous system. This gives them an incredible level of tactile sensitivity. Each whisker can detect even the slightest change in air current, allowing dogs to navigate the environment effectively, especially in low light conditions. Whisker fatigue. Whiskers can experience fatigue similar to how muscles do. When a dog is in an unfamiliar or stimulating environment, their whiskers may become fatigued from constant stimulation. This is why dogs may prefer to approach and investigate objects using their nose rather than relying solely on their whiskers. Spatial awareness. Whiskers contribute to a dog's spatial awareness. The length of a dog's whiskers is generally proportional to the width of their body. This allows them to gauge whether they can fit through narrow spaces or navigate objects without relying solely on their vision. Emotional indicators. Whiskers position can be an indicator of a dog's emotional state. When a dog is relaxed, their whiskers are typically positioned forward. If they are pulled back against the face, it can signal fear, anxiety, or submission. Observing whisker position can provide valuable insight into a dog's mood. Protective function. Whiskers act as a protective mechanism. They are highly sensitive to touch and can detect even the slightest pressure changes. This sensitivity helps dogs avoid potential hazards by alerting them of nearby objects or obstacles. Tail communication. A dog's tail is a versatile and expressive part of their anatomy, playing a significant role in communication. Here are some captivating facts about how dogs use their tail. Tail wagging. While tail wagging is often associated with happiness, its meaning can vary based on the context and the rest of the dog's body language. A wagging tail can signal excitement, friendliness, or submission. A stiff or tucked tail, on the other hand, may indicate fear or anxiety. Tail position. The position of a dog's tail provides valuable information about their emotional state. A raised tail can signify confidence or alertness, while a lowered or top tail may indicate submission. A top tail between the hind legs is a common sign of anxiety. Circular wagging. Some dogs exhibit a circular wag, where their tails move in a circular motion. This is often seen in highly excited or happy dogs. It's a joyful expression of positive emotion and is commonly observed when a dog is greeting their human or fellow canine companions. Hacking tail. Certain breeds, like the Basenji, have a unique tail behavior known as hackles. Instead of a traditional wag, their tails stand erect and quiver when they are excited or stimulated. This distinctive tail feature adds to the individuality and charm of these breeds. Tailless breeds. Some dog breeds are naturally tailless or have short tails. This trait can be a result of genetics or historical practices such as docking. While these dogs may not have a traditional tail, they often compensate for communication through other body language and vocalizations. Unique dental structure. A dog's dental structure is not only crucial to their dietary needs, but also plays a significant role in their overall health. Here are some captivating facts about their teeth. Dental formula. Dogs have two sets of teeth during their lifetime: deciduous, or baby teeth, and permanent teeth. The dental formula, which represents the number and type of teeth, is an important aspect of a dog's oral anatomy. The formula for adult dogs is typically expressed as 13/3 C11 P44 M23, totaling 42 teeth. Chewing and dental health. Chewing serves multiple purposes for dogs. That might sound strange. It helps keep their teeth clean by reducing plaque and tartar buildups. Additionally, chewing provides mental stimulation and helps relieve stress, offering appropriate chew. Teething process. Like humans, dogs go through a teething process where their baby teeth are gradually replaced by permanent ones. This usually occurs between 3 and 6 months of age. It's essential for pet owners to provide appropriate chewing toys during this period to soothe the discomfort associated with teething and encourage healthy dental development. Dental adaptation to diet. The structure of a dog's teeth reflects their dietary adaptations. Canines have sharp pointed teeth, incisors, and canines for grasping and tearing meat. The molars at the back of their mouth are designed for crushing and grinding, facilitating the consumption of a varied diet that may include bone and plant material. Carnassial teeth. Dogs possess specialized teeth called carnassial teeth, which are the fourth upper premolars and the first lower molars. These teeth have evolved for tearing and slicing through meat efficiently. Carnivores, including dogs, rely on such teeth for tearing apart prey or chewing raw meat. Dental health and overall well-being. The health of a dog's teeth is closely linked to their overall well-being. Poor dental hygiene can lead to various health diseases, issues including gum disease and infections. Regular dental care, such as brushing their teeth, providing dental treats, and scheduling professional cleanings, is crucial for maintaining optimal oral health. The intricacies of a dog's dental structure not only sheds light on their evolutionary adaptations, but also emphasizes the importance of dental care in ensuring their long-term happiness and health. Whoa, I almost said woof. Understanding these aspects of a dog's genetics, biology, and anatomy not only enhances our appreciation of these incredible animals, but also provides insights into the unique traits that make them such beloved companions. Delve into our what we call feline friends. I think it would be somewhat appropriate to identify at least five of the most famous dogs in history. So here are five of the most famous dogs in history, along with the stories behind each selection. Hachiko. Hachiko, an Akita breed, is perhaps one of the most renowned and beloved dogs in history. His story takes place in Japan in the 1920s. Hachiko's owner, Hitsaburo Ueno, was a professor at the University of Tokyo. And every day, Hachiko would accompany him to the Shibuya train station and wait for him to return from work. Tragically, Professor Ueno passed away unexpectedly, but Hachiko continued to wait at the station every day for 10 long years, faithfully waiting for his beloved owner. Hachiko's loyalty and devotion touched the hearts of many, and a bronze statue was erected in his honor at Shibuya Station, which remains a popular meeting place and a symbol of faithfulness. What a story. Number two, Balto. Balto was a Siberian Husky and a lead dog in a sled team that played a crucial role in the 1925 serum run at Nome, Alaska. An outbreak of diphtheria had struck the town of Nome, and the only way to deliver the life-saving antitoxin serum was by a relay of dog sled teams. Balto and his team, led by Musha Gona, completed the treacherous 674-mile journey through extreme blizzards and freezing temperatures, delivering the serum and saving many lives. Balto's heroic feat made him a national hero, and a statue was erected in his honor in New York City's Central Park. Liaika. Liaika was a Soviet space dog and the first animal to orbit the Earth. In 1957, during the early days of the space race, Liaika was sent into space aboard Sputnik 2. Her journey marked a significant milestone in space exploration, but also raised ethical concerns as Liaika did not survive the mission. Despite the controversy surrounding her mission, Liaika's contribution to space exploration is recognized, and she remains a symbol of pioneering effort to explore the cosmos. Number 4. Rin Tin Tin. Rin Tin Tin was a German shepherd and one of the first canine stars of the silent film era in the 1920s. Found as a puppy by American soldier Lee Duncan in a World War I battlefield in France, Rin Tin Tin was brought to the United States and went on to become a major Hollywood sensation. He appeared in numerous films showcasing his intelligence and versatility. Rin Tin Tin's legacy continues today, and his descendants have carried on his tradition in various forms of entertainment. Lassie. Lassie, a fictional rough collier character, became a beloved icon in films and television. Created by Eric Knight, Lassie first appeared in a short story and later in a novel named Lassie Come Home in 1940. The story revolves around the bond between a young boy named Joe and his loyal collie, Lassie. The character was adapted into multiple films and a long-running TV series showcasing Lassie's intelligence and courage in various rescue missions. Lassie's character had left an indelible mark on popular culture, representing the idea of a heroic and loyal canine companion. These famous dogs have left a lasting legacy, each in their own unique way, and have captured the hearts and admiration of people worldwide for their remarkable stories and contributions. Here on the YouTube channel, GNA Pet Solutions, we continue to celebrate animals, especially those that have been domesticated and those that are identified for their various contributions and even their ability to be named man's best friends. We are happy that we can be part of this legacy and that we can share this information in such a way that others can come to a realization of the capacity that such animals are capable of. We ask and even legislated to treat them equally. Hey folks, hi again. I thought I would just stick a little bit of information in before we wrapped up this video. I was doing some research and I was just curious about our American presidents, and I was wondering how popular dogs were to these presidents. Again, it's Sunday evening here on November 12th, or the month is quickly running away. And we're here on the G&E Pet Solutions channel, just trying to get you, you know, some more information, trying to get you as much as we think we can get on just this whole issue of pets, specifically dogs in this case. So I thought I would just take a quick look at our American presidents and see if dogs as pets were common to them. And interestingly, they were almost probably about more than 3/4 or 4/5 of the presidents had dogs. So I would just go through a quick list of them and just give you the names. Maybe you would want to probably use some of these names for your dogs, and just because you identify with a certain president historically or for whatever reason. Some of them, I see beginning like with George Washington, had about 5 or 6 dogs. In fact, we have him listed as having 7 dogs here. Sweet Lips, Scentwell, Vulcan, Tipsy, Drunkard, Taster, and Marge. That's quite a list. I think he probably comes in at the president with the most dogs, and probably because maybe he was a hunter also. And John Adams had 2 dogs, Juno and one he called Satan, a really interesting name. Thomas Jefferson had Buzzy and Grizzle. James Madison had Maze and Cleo. James Monroe had one called Spaniel. John Quincy James, he had Livy and Sparrow. Andrew Jackson, interesting guy, had Truxton, Bully, and Satan. This name seems to be coming up, interestingly, more than once. It's a really interesting name for a dog. I never thought about it. Martin Van Buren and William Henry Harrison, they had no dogs during their presidency. So it doesn't mean that they never had dogs. We're just looking at the periods when they were presidents. So they are noted as not having any dogs during their presidency. John Tyler, he had a dog. His name was Lebeau. I think that's the beautiful in French. James Polk, no dogs during his presidency. Zachary Taylor, he had a dog called Old Whitey. Millard Fillmore, again, no dogs during his presidency. Franklin Pierce, they said he had 7 dogs, but their names are not recorded. 7 dogs, so he may have outdone or equaled George Washington with dogs. Number 15 president, James Buckhannon, 2 dogs, Punch and Lara. Abraham Lincoln, his famous dog, Fido. Andrew Jackson, no dog during his presidency. Ulysses Grant, he had Faithful, Rosie, and 1 other dog, but their names also are not widely recorded for some reason. I think we probably didn't pay much attention to dogs in those times. Rutherford Hayes, Dot, Hector, and several other dogs, but again, their names are not widely recorded. James Garfield and Chester Arthur, they had no dogs during their presidency. Glover Cleveland, his dog's name was Hector. Benjamin Harrison, his dog's name was Dash. As the 24th president, Grover Cleveland did not have a dog during his presidency. That's just an interesting fact there. The 25th president, William McKinley, no dog during his presidency. Number 26, our famous Theodore Roosevelt. He had a couple of them, Skip, Manchu, Jack, Pete, and the research says many more. Number 27, William Taft. He had Caruso and others, again, names that were not widely recorded.
Number 28, Woodrow Wilson. His two dogs were named Davy and Mountain Boy. Warren Harding, his one dog was Laddie Boy. Calvin Coldridge, Rob Roy was one, Prudence Prim, and again others, probably not recorded. There were 31st presidents. Herbert Hoover, his one dog was named King Tut. Our famous Franklin D. Roosevelt, 32nd president, and the research said he had one whose name was Fala, and there were others whose names were not recorded. Then there was Harry Truman. His dog's name was Fella. And that has even become a slang in some countries, that name Fella. Hey Fella, what's up? Dwight Eisenhower had Heidi, Wheezy, and research said just others. John F. Kennedy had Pushinka, Shannon, Wolf, Clipper, and others. So we see quite a few of our presidents seem to have had quite a few dogs. It's just that history doesn't seem to record them. Lyndon Johnson, him and her, Blanco, and others. Richard Nixon, Checkers and Vicky. Gerald Ford, his one dog was named Liberty. Jimmy Carter had a dog named Grits. Ronald Reagan had three, and others that were not named, Lucky, Rex, and Victory. George H.W. Bush, two dogs, Ranger and Millie. Bill Clinton had Buddy and others, as they said. George W. Bush had Spot, Barney, and Miss Beasley. Our dear past president Barack Obama had Bo and Sonny. Donald Trump had one dog named Champ, and again they said others, and then our present US President Joe Biden has two dogs whose names are Major and Champ. I just thought it would be just interesting to add some of these little facts, our overall knowledge of dogs and who owned the dogs and how many dogs they had. You know, it helps us to paint us a much more complete picture of dogs and of the individuals that had them and the part that they played in history. It seems, as if you would ask me, that dogs were an integral part of our American history, because almost, well, not all, but quite a high percentage of the presidents had them, and what the record, as I said, is showing, had them during their presidency. So they may have had, those that were not identified as having dogs during their presidency may have had them outside of their presidency. Dogs are such wonderful creatures, as we have identified, such fascinating creatures with such great talent and ability to bond with human beings. And I think that's why they can be so easily found in almost all aspects of life, whether it's regular life, even all the way up to the what we would call the highest office in our democracy, that of the presidency. But again, I just wanted to add this little clippet in, so you would just continue your watching here at our YouTube channel, the G&E Pet Solutions. So be blessed and keep tuned and subscribe.